The Institute of Education Sciences is the research, evaluation, and statistics arm of the U.S. Department of Education. IES supports research that addresses important issues in education and develops solutions that improve school readiness and education outcomes for all students.
Teachers in the intermediate grades face unique challenges in meeting the reading needs of their students. The curriculum shifts from learning to read to reading to learn. Mr. Lee is a fourth grade teacher. His class has a mix of reading abilities. Some of his students are fluent readers with great comprehension. Other students struggle with reading fluently, which affects their comprehension skills. Some students, though, read fluently but don't seem to comprehend what they read very well. Mr. Lee can't figure out what's going on with this last group of students. Wouldn't it be great if a reading comprehension test could show why these students are not comprehending well? That is exactly what MOCCA, the Multiple Choice Online Causal Comprehension Assessment, is designed to do. Designed for students in grades 3-5, MOCCA identifies students like those in Mr. Lee's class who struggle with comprehension and helps uncover why they struggle. There are many reasons why students might not comprehend what they read. They may struggle with decoding, which just means reading words accurately and fluently. They might have limited vocabulary and background knowledge. But there are some students who don't comprehend well and don't fall into these categories. This is the group Mr. Lee can't figure out. Researchers have dubbed these readers poor comprehenders and have found that they are not making inferences that help them maintain a coherent idea of what a text is about. These poor comprehenders are usually trying to make sense of what they read, but they are relying on strategies that don't fully do the trick. It turns out they tend to rely on one of two strategies: paraphrasing or making connections. These are great strategies, but neither alone will result in excellent comprehension. Poor comprehenders who rely on paraphrasing are doing so excessively at the cost of making inferences that would help build a coherent understanding of the text. Research suggests that students who rely on paraphrasing need to be prompted to make inferences. Poor comprehenders who rely on making connections are making inferences, but those inferences are not always the ones that build a coherent understanding of the text. They need to be prodded to be more selective when making connections. This way, they prioritize creating a causally coherent sense of what they are reading. MOCCA helps identify whether poor comprehenders rely on paraphrasing or making connections, giving teachers the information they need to intervene effectively. MOCCA does not identify students with poor decoding or fluency skills because plenty of assessments already exist that do so. But there are no other practical assessments that provide instructionally relevant information on poor comprehenders like Mr. Lee's students. When Mr. Lee's students take MOCCA, they are asked to pick one of three choices to complete a story that is missing a sentence. The choices they make when they get items wrong provide information about the underlying strategies that they, as poor comprehenders, are using. It turns out that Mr. Lee has some students who rely on paraphrasing and some who rely on making connections. He is glad to have this unique information because now he can better group his students for more targeted instruction.
Most reading comprehension measures will tell you whether a student is comprehending and how well they're comprehending, but it won't tell you why they're not comprehending well when that's the case. And that's precisely what MOCCA sets out to do. So what MOCCA does is when students get a response or a question incorrect, the answer choices represent strategies and cognitive processes that we know poor comprehenders tend to overuse when they're reading. And so if they pick the same kind of incorrect response in a reliable manner, we're able to use that information to identify them as one of those poor comprehenders who over-relies on one specific kind of process. Because MOCCA gives teachers information about what processes readers may be overusing as they read, teachers can actually adapt their instruction as a result of that. So, for example, if a student is paraphrasing a lot, a teacher will be given information about that and suggestions that this student really needs to be prompted to make inferences when they're reading. In contrast, some poor comprehenders will make a lot of inferences, they'll make lots of connections to what they're reading, but they're not making those causal inferences, the ones that are most necessary for comprehension. So a teacher knows that they're making inferences, what they need to do is make more sort of targeted inferences that get at the why behind what a student is reading. MOCCA right now takes about a half an hour on average to administer. We think that we can get the testing time down if we use computer adaptive testing methods. and that those will also actually give us more precise or reliable scores at the same time. So there are a lot of reading comprehension interventions out there, but they all pretty much take a one-size-fits-all approach. And we believe that the information that MOCCA yields will allow us to develop more targeted interventions that get at the precise reasons that a specific reader is struggling with reading comprehension. So even though reading comprehension is something that's notoriously difficult to improve, we think that with the information yielded by MOCCA and targeted interventions, we'll actually be able to make some progress there.
The Institute of Education Sciences priority is research that contributes to improved education outcomes for all students. We fund research on new, practical, and innovative approaches that can help teachers and students successfully meet 21st century challenges.